Hello all, welcome to AuroraNews.com. In this Oracle Database Programming session, we'll discuss about the SQL developer, the ultimate IDE for Oracle Database. Okay, let us get into the objective. We should be able to understand the history of SQL developer and the available shortcuts, as well as some of the key functionalities which we generally use it. Okay. So like, what is SQL developer? It's a graphical tool from Oracle, which provides a set of functionality for us to execute the SQL scripts, PL SQL scripts, import the data, export the data, create the report, even data modeling functionality. And it is not only available to connect to the Oracle database, it is also available to connect to some of the databases like MySQL or Microsoft SQL Server, Sybase, and IBM DB2. And the initial version of the SQL developer was released in 2006, and the latest version is released in June 2020. And it is a Java-based tool. So whenever, if you want to work with SQL developer, you have to install the appropriate Java version also. We'll discuss that now. So how do you install it? Like, the basic thing is this particular software is provided as a zip file. Okay, you just need to extract and run it. There is no installation kind of thing. Actually, it happens. You just need to get the zip file. I'll just show you that. So here, if you observe into the, like, once you log into the Oracle website for the SQL developer, so here it provides a different set of versions based on your particular Windows, based on your operating system platform. It is available across all the platforms, like Windows 64-bit, 32-bit, Mac, Linux, and different set of versions. And here, if you observe, like, it is provided with here it is provided with Java included and without Java included. So you just need to consider which particular thing which you want to download. If you want to consider this one where you don't have the Java, comes up with this particular zip file. And in the earlier, this one, you know, like, the Java comes by default. This is a preferable one. So you doesn't need to install the explicit Java version. Okay. So once you get the zip file, say here, if you observe, this is a zip file. So once you extract the zip file, you'll have the content like this. You'll have a similar content like this. In the SQL developer folder, you just need to open this particular SQL developer.exe. Okay. So once you open the SQL developer.exe, so the tool may look like this. In my case, in my particular scenario, it is showing the connection. But let us say if you're open the SQL developer for the first time, you may not have any connections available. Okay. So the first thing we have to do is, as a developer, to connect to any of database, we have to create a connection. So what you have to do is you just need to click on plus symbol here, new connection, or you can also click on file, new database connection this way. Or there are many ways here. If you observe on the connections, you can right click and click on new connection. So in the connection, you just need to mention, I'll just say EBS connection. This is the connection name. This is a user-defined name. Okay, it can be anything. And it's database username, database password. And you can mention the save password also, so it doesn't need to re-enter every time. And the host name, port, SID should be provided by your DBA. Or if you have to install your database, you should be having the information. Okay. And then you can just click on test. It should be success. If it is success, it means that your connection creation is successful. I mean, the data which you provided, the username, credentials, as well as host name of your database is proper, and it will allow you to connect database. And if at all, if you want to connect as a DBA, here if you observe, as a DBA, you can mention SysDBA. And here, if you observe the connection type, you have different set of connection type based functionality also, like a LDAP, advanced, and different set of things. But in our case, I'm following the basic one. You can click on save. And just click on connect. So now it got connected to a particular database. Okay. And then, once the connection is available, you know, you can perform your particular set of SQL queries. Okay. Yeah. So now what we do is we'll try to understand some of the shortcuts which are very much used. Okay. And here, if you observe, if you want to get the file menu, we can just use Alt F. And if you want to go with the edit menu here, if you observe, this particular tool has a multiple set of menus, right? You just press Alt and you should be able to see the shortcuts. Like Alt, F is for file, E for edit, V for view, V for view, N for navigation, R for run, and H for help, T for tools, as well as O for versioning. Okay, so when you click on file, it has information about creating a connection, open the SQL file, and as well as closing the open tabs, as well as saving also. Okay, and you can also perform the exit. If at all, if you want to print it, you can also print it. So data modeling. So here, if you observe, a SQL developer data model is a different tool, but it also provides some basic set of functionality. Okay, come into the edit. So edit here, if you observe, like it allows you to perform the search, cut, copy, paste kind of functionalities, as well as find also. Okay. And coming to the view functionality, it provides, like here, if you observe, by default, you got the SQL developer open, but there are some set of windows which may not be open by default. You can explicitly open them. Example, I can tell you is like a SQL DBMS output, which you generally require when you execute a PL/SQL program. You can enable this one. And other one is log window. You can just click on view as well as log window. Can you see? So message log, this one. Okay. You can find the DB objects. Let us say if you want to find a particular table, you can just click on this one. You just need to select the appropriate connection and mention the object name. Okay. It will search the table in the provided connection. Okay. So now, so the important set of shortcuts, like when you write a query, how do you execute it, right? So you can either print, you can press Control Enter or F9. If you want to execute any PL/SQL script, you can press F5. F11 is for the commit. So here, if you observe, let us say, select start from EMP. I can press Control Enter. This is one way. Okay. I'll just say, I'll just close these two things which are not required as of. And I can press F. 1 minute. Let me show you. Okay, I press Control Enter now. Okay, F9 also works. Okay, F5. When you press F5, what is happening? It is providing the output in this particular window, the script output, not in the query result. Okay, so when you're executing a SQL query, the best thing is Control Enter or F9, these two things. And coming to the other one, like F5 is for the purpose of query result. FI is for the purpose of, you know, like a script output. And other one, like commit and rollback, when you execute, when you perform a DML operation, you can make use of F11 for the commit, F12 for the rollback. And if at all, if you want to clear the script, you can just press Control D, okay? And you can Control Z, you'll get the old information. And comment, Control Slash. Now let us say Control Slash is for comment. And similarly, again, if you press it again, it will uncomment it. Okay. That is only for the single line comment. And incremental search. If you want to search something, you can mention them. And for the purpose of describe, let us say if you want to get the information of a particular table, you can just mention a particular component and press Shift F4. You should be able to get all the information, right? Like a describe. Or you can search it by using object browser, object navigator also. So for this particular table, you have all the information like the triggers, indexes, the dependencies, and even all, you can also get the create script also. In this window, it is not showing, but there is another window where it shows the DDL script also. Okay. Alt F4 is for the closing a particular tab. And yeah, formatting is very important. Now let us say, let's try to create some table script query. Okay, I just got this query. Now I'll just select it and press Control F7. Can you see? It got formatted in a proper manner. So this is one of the very advantage shortcut to format your query. Okay. Explain plan. Yep. This also helps to find out the information about the query execution. Now let us say the explain plan shortcut is F10. Okay. Just press F10. Okay. Now what you do is you just remove the where clause here and now try to perform the F10 again. Or let us say there is another way. Yep. Some issue here. It has to come, but not sure. But this is how, you know, like you can perform the explain plan. Let me try with this table. Still I'm getting the same issue. Okay. Now other one, database search, we have just seen ALT-G. And other functionality, the one of the very critical functionality when you want to play with the data using a SQL developer, like during development stage, there are chances where you want to upload the data or extract the data or modify the data or copy the data, right? So let us see a few of them. So now let us say I want to extract the data from the database. So now let us say I got this particular query. I got the result of this query. How can I copy the resultant information from this particular query result to my Excel sheet or as a file? Right click here and you can see export option, right? You can see the export option. In the export option, you have different set of functionalities. Like you can get the data as a CSV, PDF, text, many things. Now let us say I'll select CSV. So I'll just select the appropriate folder here. Yeah. Okay, I'll just say empdata.cs. Make sure that you mention the appropriate shortcut. Okay, that's it. Now let's try to open the file empdata.csv. I'll try to open with the notepad. Can you see? I got the data in a CSV format. So this data, maybe I can use it for other purpose, right? So this is how we can export the data. This is one way. The other way of exporting data also, what you can do is you can just select your table. Like we already searched it, right? Just click on this one. Okay, now you have a data, and again the same thing, right? Export functionality, same functionality. This other way. Now in this, when you get the object browser here, you can get all the information. You can get the DDL script of this one. You can also get the triggers, indexes, data details, dependencies, many other information also. You can get it from here. Okay, and you can also create the record. You can also delete the record. Also, sometimes what may happen is instead of writing insert DML command, I can just simply, you know, like you can just click on plus symbol here. It creates a new record. Let us say 2001. Okay. New employee. That's it. Just click on commit. Right. So this employee got successful. And can you see the insert script it generated? It also provides the insert script it got generated. Okay. So now we have seen how to export the data. Let us see how do we import the data. So there are chances, you know, like you want to copy the data from other third-party system, like you want to design some other PLSQL script, but you don't have the data. But data is provided by third-party system. But initially, you want to upload the data manually rather than using any of the available logic, right? So what I'll do is I'll try to open my table. So I'll try to open my table with other way, like in this EBS connection. I'll just click on the table filter. I press apply filter, and here. XX or a EMP, remove this case sensitive. Okay, so I have the data here, right? Now I have the data in this, right? So what I'll do is I'll just clear them, delete from EMP. Oh, not EMP, sorry. XX or a EMP. Yeah. So this is what happens when you deal with the original database. Okay. Now, so I don't have any data here in the Aura EMP table. Just refresh. It's still showing, right? Let me open it again. Yep. I think I have done rollback rather than commit. Commit. Now refresh. Okay. Now the data got removed. Now what I want to do is I want to upload the data. So I'll just select your table, right click here, click on import data. Okay, click on import data. Now select the file empdata.csv, and you know, like here it gets the information, and you have to validate whether you want to what's the way you want to import. It validates set of columns also. Now it got the available columns, it selected all the columns, and here it is asking whether you want to change any of the format, right? Now here if you observe, like can you see, it is just telling what is the format you want to select. If at all you want to change it, you can change it, or else you can go with the default. For only date, it is providing an option. For other things, it is not even providing any option for you. Okay, so let's go with the default. Let's see what happens. Now you just click on verify. Now can you see it validated all the table and column names, but for the date here, if you observe, it's saying some information. For the high date, it says like invalid date or something, but still let us say I'll try to go with it. Let's see what happens. I'll click on finish. And import data into table, it says task successful and import committed. But just see whether data is available on the table or not. Can you see? So let's start from, okay. So we got the data, but check the high date. Yeah, high date is also there. There is no issue, but sometimes it got like it gave that particular warning, but still data was uploaded properly, okay? So this is how we can perform the import data. You can perform the import data, right? So you have a different set of options here. You can also validate them. And the next one is the object navigator. So what do you mean by object navigator? sorry, before that, like, let us see how do you copy the column. Sometimes what may happen is, let us say I got this data. I just want to copy this three rows. I just want to copy three rows into my Excel sheet. Let us say I'll copy like this, Control C. Now what happens? You got the data, but I want to copy with columns. I want to copy with columns. So what you do is same thing. Select your data, press Control Shift C. Instead of Control C, press Control Shift C and then Control V. Okay, let me try again. Can you see? Control V. I got the data with column names also. This generally helps when you want to find the information due to for performing some kind of debugging in the data. Okay, so other thing which we want to check out is object search. We have seen object navigator. Let us see object navigator. So object navigator means, like, when you see here, when you expand the connection, your database provides a set of components based on the object type. So these are the number of object types which generally a database provides. So based on the version, you may have a different set of things, but ideally you'll have most of these things in any of your SQL developer version, or even dependent on your database version also. Okay, so this is how you can search any of the database object type, or if you want to find out something using a in the database, you just need to press appropriate command. Other way you can do is in the view you can just click on find db object. You can mention the search. Okay, and import and export connection. Final thing is, now let us say, assume that you are new to a particular project and you have around 5 database connections to be created, and we know that it is very tough if it is a real time database where you may have a different set of passwords and it is very tough to remember and nobody remembers it. Generally they perform a copy paste. So in those kind of scenario, the best thing is you just export the connections. What you have to do is you ask your colleague to export the connections. Just click on this export connection, select all the connections, and it generates an XML file. And in your system, you can simply perform an upload connection. So I'll show you how does this data connection.xml file look like. Okay, it just has information about the username, password, whatever we entered during creation, right? You'll have everything. Okay, just see whether you have password or not. Okay, can you see password is not there? Let me try. Apps connection. Yep, user. And password is not there, so you have to ask the password. Password is not exported. Okay, so these are all about the SQL developer, some of the information tips, the mostly user functionalities. Okay, just explore them, so which will help you out during your development scenarios. Thank you.